When facing a mirror, a man will seldom take the time to observe his reflected surroundings. His eye is always drawn to his own face, his hair, his body. He fails to acknowledge that in this mirrored world, his background has also changed entirely. He only sees himself, his other. Trapped in a parallel world, he spends hours mirrored, self-splintered, yearning to one day shatter and soar.
Self-tape?
Yeah.
Okay then. Bye then.
Harpal?
Yeah?
Have a good day at work.
Charles.
What's Harpal? This is really serious. This is a serious self-tape. This is really real. This is real.
I lost my job. Because of that. Why was that in my coat? You left it in the pocket. I took a 20 bag into the office. It fell out in front of everyone. They fired me on the spot. I was almost sick right there.
You're being very serious on your birthday.
And then I started thinking on the bus. You borrow my clothes because you can't afford to buy your own. I've even covered your rent a couple times too. But somehow, you can afford to buy that every day. I never even touched the stuff before I met you. Never even thought about it. And now it's all that we do. We don't go out or do anything without getting stoned first. I don't even know what my own thoughts feel like anymore. On their own, without that. And I was thinking that on the bus. And I started feeling sick again. And I was sick. Because I was on a bus. I was sick on a bus, Charles. This isn't normal. Me and you, we're not normal.
Well, who wants to be normal then?
I was training to be a doctor before I met you. An actual doctor. And I thought I gave that up because I didn't like it. You told me I didn't like it. It's too hard. But now I'm thinking, that's what made it too hard. That's what pushed me into a shredding job, and that's what's now made me jobless. I've not even told my dad that I quit medical training because I'm too scared. And now, somehow, I've got to tell him that not only am I not going to be a doctor, but I can't even keep a job shredding paper in the back of an office. What do I do now? What's my future? And when that fell out in front of everyone, I felt, I think, the worst I've ever felt in my entire life. I feel the worst I've ever felt. And do you know what makes me feel sicker? I wouldn't be feeling like this if I hadn't met you.
Sooner, guys.
Surprise! Callan! Shall I just tell Jordan not to bother them?
No, he'll be back. Oh, doesn't like going out after dark on his own. Drink. Dance.
We might not see him again.
What?
Did this when he was 17. Disappeared for 4 days.
Why?
Scarborough Beach, East Coast.
He'll be back. And you all need to be here to show him a good time.
More drugs?
No.
deep.
It's crazy.
You know who I am.
Yeah, we just met. You're Harvey, right?
Yeah, but...
Charles's friend.
Yeah, you know who I am.
Sorry, you've lost me.
Watch Black Hoof?
Yeah, the show with the sex and the monsters and the... Yeah, I've seen that. Yeah. You're not.
Don't recognise.
You're not. You're an actor.
Yeah.
I can't believe it. I don't believe you.
Golden Globe winner.
Stop it. Really?
No one told you?
No. I don't know what to say now. But all the girls love you, don't they?
It's all fake.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, stop it.
Oh, this though. This is my jam,
you
know this?
Oh my god, this is my
your
jam.
This is my jam! Oh my god.
Yeah!
Take the floor.
Fiance.
How you doing?
Hi.
I've got one you're gonna love. Check it.
What makes you think I'd like this?
No need for that. It's not the backy wacky that bothers me. It's the fact he felt like he couldn't tell me the truth. When did he stop training as a doctor?
A few months ago.
Why?
He didn't like it.
So you talked him out of it? Now he what? Shreds paper?
Not anymore.
Good night, Charles.
We'll be back, right?
A lot of people let him down his life. I don't think he expects it to come from you too.
I promised myself to treat myself and live. Screaming to the dawn, will throw myself off in an effort to make clear to whoever what it's like when you're shattered, left standing in the lurch at a church where people are saying, my God, that's tough, she stood him up. No point in us remaining, we may as well go on as I did on my own, alone again. That only yesterday I was cheerful, bright and gay, looking forward to what wouldn't do, the role I was about to play. But as if to knock me down, reality came around, and without so much as a mere touch, cut me into little pieces, leaving me to doubt. Talk about God in His mercy, if He really does exist, why did He desert me in my hour of need? I truly am indeed alone again, naturally. It seems to me that there are more hearts broken in the world that can't be mended, left unattended. And at 65 years old, my mother, God rest her soul, understand why the only man she had ever loved had been taken, leaving her to start with a heart so badly broken. Despite encouragement from me, no words were ever spoken. When she passed away, I cried and cried all day, alone again, naturally.
Thank you. Come on, mate, it's time to drink up. Do one.
That is on me. Happy birthday.
How'd you know?
The badge.
Oh. Thanks.
So, what's a birthday boy like you doing drinking on his own?
Not been the best birthday, to be honest.
How so?
Doesn't matter.
Oh, come on, it's fine. I like to listen.
I lost my job. It was my mate's fault. My housemate. He left a packet of drugs in my coat pocket. He likes to smoke. We both do, but mainly him. He borrows my coat from time to time. It fell out at work.
Oh dear.
I know. He's... He's just...
Irresponsible.
Yeah. And... But he doesn't even work. And it's just...
A burden.
Sort of. I mean... What I mean is... I never used to smoke.
And he's pulled you into it.
Yeah.
Dragged you down, made you lethargic, undependable.
Sort of. I used to have ambition.
Motivation. Drive.
But since I started living with him, it's all just...
Drifted away.
Yeah. But we grew close, and I never really had that before. It got to the point where we'd even finish each other's...
What?
And then... Today. I don't know. Something weird.
What?
I think he's been filming me. I found wires and microphones and footage of me in my room. Hey, that's not right, is it? I mean, why would he do that? I feel like I don't really know who he is anymore.
But did you ever? Listen to me very carefully, Harpal. I think you need to get as far away from him as you possibly can.
But he's...
Oh, you'll always find 100 reasons to stay, but based solely on the information you've just told me right now, mark my words, he will ruin your life. Entirely and irrevocably. He's not your friend. Not truly. He is, by the sounds of it, an unrelenting, toxic force capable of grinding you down in every possible way without you even realizing it's happening. Trust me, I know about these things. But it's not too late. Your life could be yours again, Harpal, but only if you leave. Don't look back. Just leave.
Yeah.
Leave the city. Leave the country.
Yeah.
Right now.
Now?
Now, yes, go. Don't think about it. Don't speak to him again. Don't give him the chance to draw you back in. Don't look back.
Yeah.
Cut the dead wood. Start fresh. Be better.
Yeah. Okay.
Go. Without so much as a backwards glance. I said without a backwards glance.
Thank you. use the cards as a meditation. And those he plays never suspect. He doesn't play for the money he wins. He doesn't play for respect. He deals the cards to find the answer. The sacred geometry of chance. The hidden law of a probable outcome. The numbers lead a dance. I know that the spades are the sword.